The Director Development Response to Displacement Impacts Project at the Office of the Prime Minister, Robert Lim Lim, submitted to the Public Accounts Committee that training of youth on how to drink coffee was geared towards bringing the youth into the coffee economy.
Well, Mr. Chairman, it is important that we address also the local and domestic consumption of coffee. And we thought, Mr. Chairman, that it is right to engage our young people in this. So we did that prioritizing training. Number two, a bailing equipment. Number three, a revolving fan.
Where did you get these youth to train? When did you buy the machines? And now the machines are not there, according to the Auditor General's report. Who was going to use this coffee shop?
The MP's concerns were in response to findings in the December 2022 Auditor General's report, which pointed out flaws in the Memorandum of Understanding, which the Office of the Prime Minister signed with Inspire Africa Uganda Limited, amounting to 9.662 billion shillings, to undertake a number of activities, including teaching Ugandans on coffee consumption.
And how they were going to procure companies to train people on taking coffee. So that if we see it in your work plan, then we should be, it will answer some of these questions.
Prime Minister is reported to have spent, was it 25 billion or 25 million shillings to train Ugandans on how to take coffee. I am still looking for it.
The Office of the Prime Minister reported carrying out teaching of youth on financial literacy and business management skills at 2.652 billion shillings, while the project administration cost was 1.271 billion shillings.
You trained 500 farmers at 3.8. That means each farmer took 8 million. Capacity building, each farmer 2.6 down there. That means each farmer took 5 million. Yes, 5 million. So 5 million, 5.2 million. 5.2 plus 8, that is 13 million.
Provide all that information in a whole document, Mr. Chairman, because it helps.
So in Lira you train them to produce where coffee?
In Lira we did not train people to produce coffee. It was in Gulu.
In findings of the Auditor General, Inspire Africa was paid 1.96 billion shillings for setting up coffee shops and the attendant infrastructure in Arua, Mbale, Lira, Gulu and Tororo. However, it was established that, except in Gulu, the coffee shops were neither non-existent in some places or non-operational in areas where they were supposed to be placed.
What the Auditor General is saying, the facility does not exist and the equipment cannot be traced.
The coffee shop existed during the time we started and the training took place. We have the pictures and the reports. We have also the
pictures of what?
Of the training taking place and the functionality.
You can take a picture and we assume we're in training.
Nandala Mafabi, the Budadiri West Member of Parliament who chaired the meeting, noted that despite being the chairman of Bogisu Cooperative Union, he has never come across a coffee shop in Mbale.
Mbale City, where is yours of Mbale? Sure, where is it, the one of Mbale?
This one behind the city council. There's a new building there.
The MPs demanded for a spot check by the committee to establish the availability of these coffee shops in the districts of Lira.
Well, suspecting some foul play, I want to, where's my CID man? Yes, stand up and I see you. This case, I'm handing it over to you. We're going to provide you the quick resources today. You go and look for this equipment because the Auditor General never saw it. Maybe as police, you'll see it.
Gulu, Mbale, as well as the coffee farms in Noya and Lamo districts.
Many companies in the world, but to say there are those who deal in coffee, how did you get Inspire Africa? Just for simplicity.
I would like to request, Mr. Chairman, that you allow me to provide that evidence.
Okay.
The committee assigned a police officer attached to Parliament's Criminal Investigation Directorate, CID, to make spot checks and produce a report on their findings next week. The committee was also stunned to learn that Inspire Africa was directly procured without undergoing procurement regulations. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.